Hello everyone and welcome back. In this segment, we will delve into the core principles of inspection as outlined in ISO 17020. These principles are fundamental to ensuring the credibility, reliability and integrity of inspection activities. Overview of inspection principles. The principles of inspection in ISO 17020 revolve around three keys across competence, impartiality, and persistency. Let's explore each of these principles in detail to understand their importance and how they apply to inspection bodies. Competence. The first principle is competence. Qualified personnel. Inspection bodies must ensure that their personnel are qualified and competent. This means having the necessary education, training, skills, and experience to perform inspections effectively. Ongoing training. Competence isn't static. Continuous professional development and ongoing training are crucial to keep up with technological advancements and changes in industry standards. Evaluation and assessment. Regular evaluation of personnel to ensure they maintain their competence and can perform their duties to the required standard. By adhering to this principle, inspection bodies can guarantee that their inspections are conducted by knowledgeable and skilled professionals. Impartiality. The second principle is impartiality. Objectivity. Inspection bodies must conduct their activities objectively without any bias or undue influence. This ensures that the results of inspections are fair and credible. Conflict of interest. It's essential to identify and manage potential conflicts of interest. Inspection bodies should implement policies and procedures to avoid any situations that could compromise their impartiality. Transparency. Being transparent about inspection processes and findings helps build trust and reinforces the impartiality of the inspection body. Impartiality is crucial for maintaining the integrity and trustworthiness of inspection results. The third principle is consistency. Standardized methods. Inspection bodies must use standardized methods and procedures to ensure that inspections are performed consistently. This means following documented processes that are regularly reviewed and updated. Uniform application. Applying these methods uniformly across different inspections helps ensure that results are reliable and comparable. Continuous improvement. Consistency also involves continuously improving processes based on feedback and audit findings. This helps maintain high standards and adapt to new challenges. Consistency ensures that inspection results are reliable and can be trusted by clients and stakeholders. Integration of principles. These three principles, competence, impartiality, and consistency, are interrelated and together form the foundation of effective inspection practices. Competence ensures that inspections are carried out by qualified personnel. Impartiality guarantees that inspections are conducted without bias. Consistency ensures that the same high standards are applied to every inspection. By integrating these principles into their operations, inspection bodies can uphold the highest standards of quality and reliability. Implementation of principles. Implementing these principles requires a structured approach, policies and procedures. Establishing clear policies and procedures that align with these principles. Training and development. Investing in the continuous training and development of personnel. Monitoring and evaluation. Regularly monitoring and evaluating inspection processes to ensure compliance and identify areas for improvement. This structured approach helps inspection bodies maintain their competence, impartiality, and consistency over time. In conclusion, The principles of competence, impartiality, and consistency are essential for ensuring the integrity and reliability of inspection activities as per ISO 17020. Adhering to these principles helps build trust with clients and stakeholders and enhances the credibility of inspection results. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions about these principles or how to implement them in your organization, please feel free to ask now. Now let's open the floor for questions. And if you have found value in our videos, please do subscribe to our channel and share it with your professional colleagues. Thank you.